Hello, my dear viewers. I am here before you with my channel PCM Guru Bro. This is based on the physics, chemistry, maths, Guru, and Brahman, that is shorter to Bro. So, this is a sister concern of my institute named GEMS, which is in Kerala, Trivandrum district, and there is Varkala. In Varkala, Ayur village, and in Kalathara bus stop. This is situated, and from this most modern media, online media, by the help of YouTube, I am trying to make you acquainted with the tuition which is available for students of class 12th and also up to the college level. Starting from 8th standard. So here, right now I am dealing with class 12th physics, chemistry, maths. So today's class in the maths, we are dealing with the first chapter, relations and functions, in the class 12th CBSE or the plus 2 higher secondary examination board. So the questions, first chapter questions, we will solve today four board examination questions. The what are all videos I put before you, these are all very researched questions which will be probably asked in examinations. I will write VIQ, that is very important questions. I will write this frequently asked questions, etc. Because, for a YouTube content, I think that it is not necessary to make you understand the whole big vast lesson, just to make you prepared for the examination. For the examination, the examination based questions, I will just make you acquainted with what are all necessary aspects you should know, and then with that I will make you very much able to solve that problem or that question, giving you the necessary information, data, and the systemic form. So today, in the first chapter of the class 12, we are going to solve four board examination questions, including the relations and functions. There is also another episode or part which I have included in the sets, relations, functions, the basic core top secret videos, the top secret level content video, to make you understand what is really going inside, what is really inside that concept of set, relation, and function. So by now it will be helpful for you to understand, but this I will help you for solving the four problems here. What role, if a manuscript is given, there is a need of interlinking steps. So I will include that and make you understand by verbal conversation. These are all the essential needs to understand maths to its fullest. So the first question is asked in March 2018, the board examination level question, which is asked, f of x is equal to x by x minus 1. F of x, the function of x, now it is represented by x by x minus 1. And in that, x is not equal to 1. Why this x is not equal to 1? Because if we put 1 here, 1 minus 1 is 0. So this will not be defined. Function will not be defined. So we will give a condition that x not equal to 1. And find the f of x and find the inverse of f. By earlier that video, please try to see this whole manuscript which is written, writings, in the maximum clarity possible. I will try to make it so interesting for you all, but understand the thing that these are all writings. It should be viewed in the maximum clarity possible. And I will also read it, what all I have written. I will just point out and read it to you all. But just try to download or see this manuscript in the maximum clarity possible, so that I am trying to make you understand in the most enjoyable way. So each word I am trying to make you understand. If you have a missing in the fundamentals, I will help you. That's the thing in this in the videos which I am making, to make you very strong in the fundamentals. That's the thing here. So be with me, support my channel, like, share and subscribe, be the content of my channel, be in your gossip area also, so that I know that if you gossip about these examination board questions, you know, I will be profited because you all get good marks by seeing my videos. That's the essence. So the thing is that function is given, that is a condition, x if it is put 1, that will get undefinable, undefined. So x not equal to 1, this function is defined. Find f of x. First of all, I have told you that f of, this is written like this, f of, function of a function, it can be written in mathematical form like this, f of a square bracket inside that f of x. Okay, so this of symbol now is replaced by this square bracket. So we will write f of x is equal to f of square bracket f of x. So in that square bracket f of x, now just put what is f of x value, put that inside. This whole thing, you know, is single. This whole thing is considered as a single thing. So f of this whole thing is equal to this whole thing, it is written now, this whole thing, then that whole thing by that whole thing minus 1. That means f of x by x minus 1, that means this whole thing by this x by x minus 1, that whole thing minus 1. Do you understand? This whole thing, what is inside now, that by that minus 1. This then, this by this minus 1. Okay. So by this, if we want to solve this, no, by opening what rule is needed. So let it be x by x minus 1 written like that. X by x minus 1, okay, same as, but we can change the denominator now. So making the denominator here to be x minus 1. Okay. So multiplying numerator and denominator by x minus 1. So I have written like this, 1 by 1. Into x minus 1 into x minus 1. Okay, so this same thing now is again processed to form like this. Okay, that means the same denominator is there, x by x minus 1. So x minus x plus 1. Okay, plus of minus x plus 1. So x by x minus 1, I have written same like this, x minus x plus 1 written like this, x minus 1 is common denominator, so written like this. This x minus 1, this x minus 1 cancelled out, x minus x 0. That cancel out, remaining is x by 1 into 1 by 1. That is what, if a ratio of fractions is given, then a by b by c by d is equal to a by b into d by c. That form, x we got. Okay, and then find the inverse of f. If the function is this now, what is the inverse? Inverse means this is a function. First of all, if you don't know anything also, the inverse of f, this a function means, you know, a which is written in a variable of x, that is function of x. Okay, function of x means something which is written in a form of x. So this will be given a name y. Okay, earlier we know f of x is equal to x by x minus 1, but this thing will be given a name y. So y is equal to x by x minus 1. We can write y by 1 is equal to x by x minus 1. Then just this y into x minus 1, we can take it to the left side, and 1 into x, the other side. Okay, this is the processed one. Just write y is equal to x by x minus 1 and process this, cross multiply and make it like this. Again, no, make it xy minus y. Okay, xy minus y, or yx minus y is equal to x. This is a simplified of this. This is going like this. This form will get this form. This will get to this form. And then this, no, we can put this x to the left side and this minus y to right side. So this here, the y will become plus y and x will become minus x over here. So this is right. Yx minus x is equal to y. This x when getting to the left, minus x. This y to the right, then plus y. So yx minus x is equal to y. X is equal to y. So what is remaining? Take x as common. X common, then y minus 1 is equal to x into y minus 1 is equal to y. So making x to the one side, x is equal to y by y minus 1. This is the inverse here. That means something which is in the form of, earlier we have found a function with respect to x, now x by x minus 1. Then the function with respect to y is the inverse. Okay, so inverse of f is x is equal to, inverse of f is equal to x is equal to y by y minus 1. This is the inverse. Okay, understood. So making Whatever all function is given, writing it f of x, if it is in the variable x, f of x is equal to x by x minus 1, then put the f of x is equal to y, then rearrange in a form that isolate x to the other side and find an equation which is based on y. That is this. So, x is isolated in the left side, no? Likewise, which I have done earlier, y is on the one side, no? Likewise, we just isolate x to the one side, and what is left, equation which is in the form of y, no? Which is based on y, is the inverse. Understood? That's it. So, try this, practice this. Finding function of a function and inverse. Just by isolating whatever all the function is based to one side, and it making it to the other variable base, okay, it is making in the other form with the this x by x minus 1 is f of x, no? So name it y and take this x to one side and making an equation which is based on a variable y. That's the inverse. That's it. Then comes the first chapter, which include binary operations. Binary operations means it will contain two things and they are operated with a law, and it will be given a law in the question. A law will be given in the question. The second question is asked in the March 2018 question. Okay, same as this. It is asked, let A is equal to N into N. That means a natural number into natural number. Okay. A is equal to a natural number into natural number, and star B a binary operation on A. Okay. This is a binary operation, okay, star operation, okay, n, this is an operation on natural number, and the star is the operation on this, A star A, okay, so find 1, 2, star, 2, 3, but defined, the operation A is defined like a way, a binary operation which is defined on A is, okay, reading. I am going in a haste. Just I want to read this. Let A is equal to N cross N. That is natural number, the natural number relation. And star be the binary operation on A. Okay, star is the binary operation. So, binary operation is depicted by a symbol like this. Which is written, represented by a symbol like this. And A is defined by this binary operation on A. This A is defined as A, B star, C, D is equal to A plus C, the first things should be added, comma, second things to be added. Okay. Then there it is asked to find 1, 2 and 2, 3. Okay. And second is that prove that this binary operation is commutative. And prove that this binary operation is associative. Okay. On the way, we will understand what is commutative, associative and doing this thing. First of all, what is given? 1, 2 and 2, 3. Okay. Similarize with the position which is given like this, A, B, C, D, then A plus C, no, this is the first thing. That means 1, 2 star 2, 3 is equal to, what is the position of A and C, A plus C, this dot, no, 1 plus 2. And what is the position of B plus D, this 2 plus 3, no, which I have written, that is represented by the dot of 1 and 2 have dot and 2 and 3 have a triangle. Okay, these two get added. So, 1, 2 star 2, 3 is equal to 3, 5. That's enough. And then comes this proving A, B star, C, D is equal to. The thing is that proving that star, this binary operation is commutative. This binary operation is commutative. We want to prove. So what is commutation? Commutation means we can interchange itself, which can be written like this here. Proving that AB star CD is equal to CD star AB. That's the commutative law. This thing star, this operation, AB operation CD is equal to CD operation AB. But look at this. We can try this. AB star CD is equal to, in the question itself, A plus C, B plus D. Okay. And when we write CD star AB is equal to C plus A and D plus B. Okay. Look this. These are same now. A plus C is equal to C plus A. Any two numbers added, reversed, same now. B plus D or D plus B, they are same now. So, thus proved. This is commutative. Thus, AB star CD is equal to CD star AB. Thus, this binary operation is commutative. That's enough. Proving the associative law now. This is the associative law. We can just take another set, EF now. So, A B star S a flower bracket is there. C D star F is together. So associated, which is connected to one, and is equal to A B and C D is associated the next thing, and which is with the binary operation of E F. So understand, no? Association of C D and E F and association of A B C D and their connection, no? Like this. A B star flower bracket. This law is association law. We want to prove that this is true. That's the question which is asked. Prove that the associative law, no? We have put it along with what are all given, no? A, B, C, D, we have put another A set, and just associating the second with the third and the first with second. Okay, again, the second and third are associated and the first and second are associated, which is linked with the third. First is 1 and 2, 3 is solved, and then 1, 2 and 3 is solved. Okay, so this is the associative law. Just by heart, this is the law. Association of two things is equal, and into the processing of the first thing is equal to association of first two thing and the processing of the third. Okay, this is the associative law. Okay, so we can prove that just by, we can take the LHS. CD star EF is equal to C plus E by D, C plus E comma D plus F. It is written over here now. And then the whole thing is closed. This operation is over. Then here is this star means the first thing A plus C plus C. Here A B star C plus C, then A plus C plus E. It is written over here comma B plus D plus F. Okay, by this law, A plus here, A plus, this A plus, C plus E, and B plus, what is over here? B plus, what is over here? This is this. So, in the RHS section, first we can solve this thing. So, A plus C and B plus D, it is written same. But when it comes to this, no, A plus C plus E, okay, A plus C plus E, first thing, this thing plus this, B plus D plus F. Look, these two are same, no? Hence associative, hence proved. Okay, so this is the question which is asked in board exam. So just practice. The first chapter is easy, but even still, you must practice to make it faster for you to turn to other questions of very difficult manner. So March 2017 question is. As the relation R is defined on 1, 2, 3 by R is equal to 1, 3, 3, 1, 2, 2. It is given R is, it is an objective question which is asked. R is symmetric or reflexive or transitive or reflexive but not transitive. Choose the following. Then I just, the truth answer is symmetric. Why no? I will tell you. Basically what is reflexive? Reflexive means no. Everything is related to its own. The set should have 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. Is there? A 2, 2 is only there. Okay, not that sure. It is reflexive only for one of the points which is to be said. Okay. In the case of transitive, no, there should be a transition point. That means 1, 3. Okay, 1 and 3 are taken. Then 3, 1 is taken. Then comes 1, 1. That means AB. B, B, C, then A, C. That's the thing, transitive relation. Okay, here 1, 3 and 3, 1. There is no 1, 1. So, leave it. Not transitive, not reflexive. Then comes commutative. That means 1, 3 is taken, then 3, 1 should be there. Okay, it is inside, no. So, just commutative. This law only have a full commutative law. Okay, a thing is made commutative. Not that there is fully reflexive things over here. Just commutative law is over fully over here. 1, 3 if taken, the commutative law is there. So, I will prefer the symmetric commutative. Okay. So, this is symmetric relation. This is symmetric. This is symmetric thing. So, this if there is another relation also, that means this reflexive, commutative and transitive, when together it is called equivalence relation. Okay, if it is for your acquaintance, you just want to know that if these three things are there in the set, now if these three things are inside that set, now you just say that this is equivalence relation. Okay, if three things are satisfied, that is reflexive, transitive, then commutative, then that means symmetric is commutative. Yeah, symmetric is commutative, this is the same as commutative, and reflexive, commutative and transitive, it is called equivalence relation. Okay, then comes find f of g and g of f. This f of g, no, what if it is f of x is given x plus 1. Okay, modulus of x plus 1. G of x is equal to x minus 1. Then f of g of x, I will write f of the square bracket g of x. Okay, what is g of x? 2x minus 1. Put over there. Then f of x is equal to modulus of something. F of that thing is equal to modulus of that thing plus 1. That means modulus of 2x minus 1 is equal to modulus of 2x minus 1 plus 1. Okay, then minus 1 and plus 1 get cancelled out. The answer is modulus of 2x. Then g of f of x is equal to, we will just write g of square bracket f of x is equal to g of square bracket, what is f of x value? Modulus of x plus 1, x plus 1. Then g of x is equal to, in the, what role inside that g of x now? 2 into that thing minus 1. So 2 into this whole modulus of x plus 1 minus 1. This is the answer. And the third question is, let star be a binary operation defined on n natural number to natural number by a b star c d, a plus c b plus d. Find the identity element for star, that binary operation. Identity element is something, if it is binary operated, no, that will yield that element itself. That's the identity element. But here, no, it will lead to a complex answer. It is written at the bottom. I have just made it to know that A, B, star, II. Okay, this is the identity element. First of all, to know this, I will solve another question which is asked in the exam-oriented base. It is asked. So, just by solving that, you will get a basic idea, and then we can solve this. What binary operation? Find the identity. Identity element if possible, if it is existing. So the answer is, there is no identity element, it does not exist, because element is not in pure form. This is not a single for identity element. No, it should have only a single element. Okay, here it is a group, a set is taken, no, like that, a b c d, like that. So it is not in pure relation, element is mixed or added. So that's the answer. There is no identity element. But to make you understand, we can solve another problem. Let star be a binary operation defined on Z by A star B is equal to A plus B minus 15. Okay, this is the binary operation. A star B is equal to A plus B minus 15. It is defined on integers. Find the identity element in Z and the binary operation. Okay. Find the inverse of the element in Z and that binary operation. Okay. By now, identity operation, identity element, we can find. First answer, let I be the identity element. I for identity element. Then that element, binary operation I is equal to identity element, binary operation A is equal to A. You will get same A. A star I is equal to I star A is equal to A. For all A element of Z, A is an element of integer. So, A element of I, no, by this law, A element of I means A plus I minus 15. I have written like this. I element of A, I binary operation A, no, then I plus A minus 15. This, no, same thing. Again, this sign, this thing for this and this for this. So, I will get a value of I is equal to 15. That is, identity element value is equal to 15. That element should be binary operated with a element, so that it will have a commutative nature and it will give the same answer, that element itself. Okay, so the identity element I is equal to 5. So in the next question, it is asked the inverse. No, so B, let the B be the element of that in integers, be the inverse of A element of Z. Let B be the inverse. Understand? So if B is the inverse, then the binary operation A star B is equal to identity element we will get, and B star A, This is the condition. Okay. So for inverse, no, that inverse when binary operated will give identity element. That element, if binary operated, will give identity element. So A star B is what? A star B, we will find out A plus B minus 15. Okay. B star A what? B plus A minus 15. Okay. Then I is what from earlier question? I is equal to 15. We have found now. So I we have heard. So A we know that now. So B is equal to 15 plus 15. That means 30. 30 minus A. Okay. 15 plus 15, 30. 30 minus A is equal to B. B is what? The inverse of A. B is the inverse of A. That is 30 minus A. Okay. Understood. This is the question which you want to revise also and understand well. The thing is, we can take the same identity element, finding the identity element in this, you know. So I have found A star, B star, II. This is the identity element, okay, of this set. Then II star AB. Okay, what is the answer of this? That AB star II, then A plus I, comma B plus I. Okay, and this is what finally operated then? I plus A, I plus B. This should be equal to AB now. Then when I is equal to 0 only, this A plus I or B plus I or I plus A or I plus B will become AB. Okay, so I is equal to 0. This identity element is 0 or it doesn't exist. 0 is the identity element of everything now when added in the case of addition. 0 is added to anything that it will only give the same. So 0 is not considered as a natural number thing. So a natural number is the thing which is under consideration. So that will not be accepted. Okay. So 0 is not considered. So the identity element is not finite value, having some value now. So it doesn't exist. Or otherwise we can say, this identity element star CD or CD star that identity element is equal to CD. This is to be proved. So I can only have the value 0. Solving now, I plus C and I plus D, C plus I, D plus I. This identity element is equal to 0. So we can say that the identity element doesn't exist. That is which is written over here. There is no identity element. It doesn't exist. Element are mixed, added or together. Element is not in pair form relation. That's can be said the identity element does not exist, because in the natural number, no, it will not exist. That's the answer. Yeah, if you have any doubt, call me. You know, this is an educational channel. My institute's name is GIMS Mathematical Science Institute, Jehoshua Institute of Mathematical Sciences. So in the condition, every institute is under problem of not having that full-fledged running. So this is a venture to make you understand the concepts, very important exam oriented, board exam oriented concepts. Even if I am making the best video itself, without your support I cannot survive. So please, yeah, be kind to me. Please support, like, share, subscribe my channel. Whatever all I am teaching you, just make it a gossip in study circle with your friends. Just practice well, get good marks. I'll be with you. I'm your very brother, bro. Be happy, be cool, stay safe. Be cool, yeah. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.